you ever had any problems like this?
What is broken?
Why don't you try looking at a previous version?
Oh sh! I did not save any previous version.
Audius?
Yes, I have fixed the UI bug.
Hey wait, I'm also fixing that engine bug too.
You're working on it also? And how are we supposed to merge our change together?
Well, I don't want to copy and paste and rearrange and rearrange again.
How about this?
Stupid EE. My god, what is this function? Who wrote this? I want to kill him.
You'll be able to avoid all of these problems if you choose Git. Many of you are probably asking, but what exactly is Git? Git is a version control system, which means that when you make changes to your source code, it will track and record a history of all those changes. Git is also distributed, which means that as opposed to having a central server, all users will have the entire history stored on their machines. So why should you use Git as opposed to other version control systems? First of all, because Git is easy to use. If you're just using Git on your own project, there's no need to set up a complicated server since Git supports storing everything locally. Secondly, as opposed to traditional version control systems where you can't do anything without a connection to the server, Git works fine without an internet connection. Third, Git supports all major operating systems, whether it is Windows, Linux, or Mac OS X. Finally, and most importantly, it's free. You can freely use Git for your personal and commercial projects without any limitation. Next, allow me to briefly explain how Git works internally. A Git repository is basically a folder called .git in your source folder. Everything related to Git is stored in there. When you edit a file and commit the changes, the old version will remain in the repository. This is a typical workflow using Git. First, if you're working on a shared project, you have to clone the entire repository from the server to your local machine for the first time. Then, you make the desired changes to your file. After that, you will need to commit the file in order to save the new version to the repository. When you commit, you will need to write a commit message to describe your changes, and that will be stored in the history when you need to refer to the changes in the future. Finally, if you are working on a shared project, you have to push the committed changes back to the server. Next, consider a situation where there are two people and both have made changes to the source code. The first person will be able to push the changes back to the server as usual. But when the second person tries to push the changes, it will be rejected. He will then have to pull the changes made by the first person. If the changes are made to different places, Git will be able to merge the changes automatically. Finally, you can then push the merged changes back to the server. Branching is known as one of the killer features of Git. Imagine you want to add a new feature to your software, but you're not sure yet if it will work out or not, and you just want to try it. You can do this by creating a branch to work on your new feature and do all other normal development on a master branch. When you think the new feature is good enough and should be merged, you can easily merge it back into the master branch. Now you have just discovered that something is broken. Don't panic. This is where Git shines. You have many options such as looking through the history to see if there are any recent changes that might be the cause. Or you can see what changes were in a specific revision. If that's a line that you don't understand, you can also see who wrote it and when. It is also very easy to revert back to a working version. One of the most popular websites for Git users is GitHub, which provides free Git hosting for your open source projects. GitHub provides a nice website where you can browse all of your code, see changes, and check the history all from your browser.
However, Git is not without its disadvantages.
So you just have to type it like this?
Oh. I think it is too hard to use. It is too complicated for my simple program.
As you have just seen, it can be hard to learn, especially for people who have no experiences with version control before. But don't let that prevent you from using it. Once you have learned it, it can be very useful. Another issue some people complain about Git is that its revision numbers can be confusing. With traditional version control system, the revisions are named 1, 2, 3, 4, and so on. However, with Git, it's like this. As you can see, all revisions are basically random characters. Finally, because Git stores the entire history on your computer, it can take quite a lot of disk space. For example, the source code of the Linux kernel is 600 megabytes large, but you include all the history, it's quadruple to 2 gigabytes.
If you would like to know more about Git, please take a look at the following resources.